collection runner allows you. So using GUI, we were testing it one API at a time, right? We can't test like all the APIs within a collection in one go. So this is where collection runner help us. So using collection runner, this is how a collection runner looks like. So using collection runner, what you can do, you can provide your collection, you can provide your environment. You can also provide the iteration count. Iteration count is, let's say you want to run your collection 2 times, 3 times, 4 times. So then you can provide this. And if you want a delay, let's say I want a delay of 100 milliseconds between each request. So I can provide that. And then this is where you can do the data-driven testing. This is where you can provide a CSV file or a JSON file, which can help you to do a data-driven testing. You'll see the demo today using CSV file. So let's see what we need. So for data-driven testing, let's say we have a login API. Okay. We already saw a login API of Staging Engineer AI that needs username, or we can say email and password, right? So rather than giving this particular detail in GUI, so let's create a collection. Okay, let's create a sample collection. Name it data driven tests. You can also do it like I'll do in the speed which where you can also follow. So I created a collection, right? Under that I will add a request. I'll name it as login API. My throat is not good today, guys, so bear with me. And let's say here I would add my login API. So this is my endpoint, method type is post. I guess all of you already went through this API multiple times, so I don't need to show you everything. Payload is this. Okay, and we need a header content type. Okay, so I guess somebody has changed the password of this user. Can any one of you give me a user where login is working? Any user will work for the demo purpose. Anyone? No. Okay, let me create a user then. Okay, A5. Thank you, Srini. Okay. So let's say this is our login user and I do something like this and I get results, right? But let's say on a functional testing level or a manual testing level, you need to test it for, let's say, 1,000 user or 1,000 combination, right? So our test case could be correct username, correct password, correct username, incorrect password, incorrect username, correct password, incorrect email, incorrect password. And similarly, we need to test it like various combination with capital letters, with small letters, password with less character, more character, special character, okay? So there could be n number of test cases within this particular username and password field. How do we test this? Do we test it manually? Do we test like fuzzy testing kind of thing where we provide lot of data and test it like a brute force attack or something? Do we test it manually? That will take a lot of time. So this is where data-driven testing will help us. So we provide all this data in the CSV file, and then we replace it here, the variables of column name here, and then it will take it that variable and run those tests on those data. Now, how do we get the data? So in test cases, there is a problem. I'll show you the problem. Let's first create a CSV. So for that, we need a CSV. So this is one test which is working. Damodar, why are you keep entering and leaving? This is one test which is keep working. Now let's create a CSV file. So let's create a CSV file with say email, comma, password. Okay. And let's try to add our test cases. So correct one is this, comma, now with this I create multiple combination. Okay, let's say with A51 incorrect. So here correct username, correct password, correct username and correct password with capital A, then wrong email, correct password, then correct email, wrong password, and wrong email, wrong password. Okay. So let's save it. And I say all file and save it as data.csv. Okay, so now what I will do, because here you can see I added two variables, email and pass. So I will replace this particular thing with email and pass using variable tag. So this is my variable tag. Similarly, the pass is pass. This is again my variable tag. So I replace this with CSV data variable name. So I added two variable name in CSV data, right? Email and pass. So I replaced it here. So let's save everything. Okay. And I think we are ready for the test. So now to run the test, we need a collection runner. So you can click on runner. Okay. And now, since we don't need any, so first of all, let's look for our data-driven collection. Here, I have not specified any environment yet. We will do that later on. Iteration, I leave it one. Delay, I leave it as it is. Now here, we need to select the file. So if I select this, there is a preview option. So this, using this point, there is an option to select. Like if you are providing a JSON file, you can select this. If you're providing CSV file, you can select this. And then you can click this to see if everything is correct, like data is correctly displayed. So you can see in iteration one, this data will be taken. In iteration two, this data will be taken, and so on. Okay. So by using this preview data option, you can verify that your file has correct data. Everyone is with me till now? Before we go to the next step, type 4 if you are with me. Cool. So now we just have to run it. So I have selected my this particular API. You can see here, if you have multiple options or multiple APIs, you can select or deselect. Like I want to test data driven on particular test only, right? I don't want to test data driven on, let's say, get APIs. That is not needed. So here you can select only post APIs. Select all and deselect all our options are also there. So this is basically the console viewer to filtering out the APIs where data driven tests are needed. Now, once that is done, you just have to click on this run data driven test. Okay. So when I run this, okay, so I did not edit any test, so that's why you can see 00. But let's see this. So the first test was correct username, correct password, it passed. Second test was capital email and but correct email, correct password with capital email. So if you remember, I told on WhatsApp also, there is an issue going on in backend API where if you have a capital email in backend API test, it will not work. So that's why you see this 422 entity error. The third, fourth, fifth are basically wrong details, right? That's why everything failed. So this is the results looks like, and this is how you can do data-driven testing. Type 5 guys, if you can see the same results in your collection runner console. Anyone, any issue, any question? If you have any questions right now, you can ask it, because going forward it will become more complex.
Hello, Chandan.
Yes, can you type in chat?
Yes.
Let me unmute you, everyone. No, CSV only. So Excel, you can use Excel, but as a CSV file. The extension should be CSV only. It will not work for XLS or XLX format. Okay, you can use, so if I do something like WP sheets, I can create a CSV file also. Sorry, Excel file, but the extension should be CSV. Okay, so obviously when you work with a large data set, you will not be able to add everything in Notepad, right? So there, what you can do, you can open any Excel editor or sheet editor, create a blank sheet, okay? Here you can say email, pass, okay, 1111. 2222, and then finally you can save this as a CSV extension. Obviously, when you work on large data set, you use this kind of thing. So here you have to select the CSV extension. This one, and you can say save, and now you can use this file also. Okay, so this is kind of an Excel file, but the format should be always CSV. I hope it is pretty clear. Or JSON. In JSON, what do you have? You provide data in JSON format. Okay. Now I think if everything is ready, everyone is ready with this test. Like, the problem with this is basically, how do we write test in this? So when we write test in this console, so when we go here, we say, let's say we add a test PM. Okay. By the way, if you are not familiar, this script console is actually also having autocomplete feature. So when you say PM, it will actually give you what you write. So I want to write PM dot expect. Okay. And when I say something like this, it will tell me what to expect, value, message, something. So in a string, I want to expect my PM dot response dot code, like status code. I want to expect this to be equal to, let's say, 200. Okay, this is one of my tests. Now, to consider this as test, I need to add it in a test format. So I would say PM dot test. Now, when I do that and open the bracket, it tells me what to do. So I need to have a string message of test name and then a function, JavaScript function. So I will say verify status code, comma, let's say function. Okay. And then I need to close out and open and close curly braces. Under that, I will add the function. Now here I would add all my test cases. So this is my test case. Okay. So this is my assertion. I want to verify my status code should be equal to 200. Okay. Okay, I'll check. Give me some time, Srini. Let me finish this demo. Okay, so if I test it as a single test, okay, so right now we are not using any CSV file in single test, it will fail. So when I do that, okay, wait. When I do that, so test passed, right? Verify status code passed. But the problem with data-driven test is, if you can see this status code is different every time, right? It is for correct, so it will work for this, the test code will work for this, but it will not work for this. Or it could be different also, right? Sometime you can get 404, sometime you can get 405. And so basically, if you do negative testing, the codes will be different every time. How do you verify this with data-driven testing? So any input, guys? How can we do that? Not parameter, within this test itself. Yeah, so you can use variables, and you can use variables in code also. So what we will do, we will add one more parameter, let's say expected status code. And let's say for verifying one more thing, let's say when we get the response, we would verify this message also. There is a message in this response, whether the sign-in is successfully or not. Again, this will change. If it is wrong, let's say if I give something wrong, that message changes, right? So this message becomes this one. So how do you verify this kind of thing where the message or response data and status code is different based on different test case? So this is where what we can do, we can reuse our data-driven test, but with extra value. So here within our Excel file or CSV file, we can add two more fields, let's say expected message and expected status code and expected response message. So, but we get the actual output from the code or from the test, but we match it for expected output with this particular Excel file or CSV file. So now what we can do here, we can say expected code in terms of correct should be 200, right? And expected message would be, so in case of correct, the expected message is 200. Make sure you copy correctly. There should be no spaces or anything. Carefully. Okay, similarly, the other API becomes 422. 422. 422 and this message becomes, so when I do something wrong, you can get the message. This message becomes this one. Right. So what we are doing, we are not dependent on test now. We are actually verifying our expected output from here. So now based on iteration, so for iteration one, this will be checked. Iteration two, this will be checked and so on. Now we wrote this code here, or we parameterize in CSV, but we need to make sure that we verify based on parameter here also. So let's say one of other tests is verify response message, right? And then in here I would say pm.response.json, because I need to fetch out the message JSON path, right? So I will say JSON and dot message, because this is direct, right? There's no child here. So dot message, if you want, you can take it to the JSON path extractor again. And click this. So this is direct. Okay. So here I need to verify that the message in this thing is basically this, right? So these are my two tests. When I run is right now it will fail because correct email is not there, but now it should work. Okay. Sign in failure, wait. It should have the value like this. So my tests are working, okay, for single test right now. But the point here is we are doing it with the hard-coded value, or let's say when we use environment or global value, you'll be using these values, property values. But what happens when we have multiple values for the same test? This is where we need to use slightly different approach. So now this is what happens when you write a single test, right? Now, everyone with me, So I will do changes later if you are not with me also. So I wanted to show you what will happen when you run single test versus when you run data driven test. So now again, I would change that to my email. And here I would change that to my password. So once that is done, so I need to do some changes here also. So for that, let's say I have to create some variables. So first, let's say I create a JSON data variable which have all the data or which has a JSON. So for that, I would use this one. Or I can say where I need three things, right? I need response code, I need message, and what else? Response message. Yeah, I need two things. So I would say actual status code. Similarly, I would say actual response message. And here I would replace this one. And here I would replace this one. Okay. So this thing I would replace to a actual message, actual status code. This thing I would replace with actual status response message. Now I need to replace these two things. How can we replace that? Okay. So you can do that using, so if you need to get anything from Excel file or CSV file, so let's say I need to get status code. So you can do that PM using same variable kind of technique for collection variables and other, but this time you have iteration data. Okay, iteration data. So when you do that dot, so it has certain method set, unset, get. So we will use iteration data, PM dot iteration data dot get. Okay, if I do get, you would see it needs a key. That's it. So I need to give the key. So key here is basically this one. These are all keys. Okay, if you are on JSON, the field name is key. So I need to extract this. So how can I do that? I will just copy this and come here, and that's it. You can extract the value, right? So rather than saving in variable, I can directly copy it and use it in this. So I can say this should be equal to this one. And similarly, I would say message for message, this should be equal to the expected message. I'm trying to copy paste because then there would be no issue of typing errors. Okay. So now what I did, I modify my test to extract the data from the Excel file and then verify with the runtime output. And then now it would work with every kind. So we don't need to check now for each test. It will take the data using parameters present in Excel, and then it will get the data in iteration data. And for each status code, it will verify. In iteration one, it will verify for 200. In iteration two, it will verify for 422, and so on. Is it clear, guys? Are you with me? Why in red? What is in red? This one? How used to be like earlier. This signify if I make some mistake, this signify. So if I use, let's say, some variables, username, right? which is present in my username. So this is basically coming from, so how is that is look like? Like it used to be same for me every time. It does look like different for you. Okay, it does not matter actually. If I think maybe I'm on like latest version or something. What else? Will single quote and double quotes both string? Yeah, both will work. But in JavaScript, we'll try to use single quotes. Okay, especially if you are working with variables. If you are working with string, then you can type like double quotes. No, not error. I earlier also, like when we ran actual test, data-driven test, it worked, right? So it was not an error, and it will work later on also. This just signifies that this is particular values from variable, okay? And so if I do something like this, this signifies this is a hard-coded value, like which comes in blue, right? And if I use variables, then it comes as red because it signifies that this is a variable. In our case, it is email. Okay, email is not coming because that is part of data driven. It comes from all the variables, collection, environment, globals. But since it is from data driven, it is not coming. But otherwise, if you want to see, these one will come. So if I say password, it will actually capture the password. See, current environment file. Okay, anyway, let's save it, and I will give you this script also. So if you are writing it live, you can use this script. Okay, so it will not work for single test, right? As I said, we have completely changed it. Iteration data driven test. So it will not work for single test, but when you are doing data driven testing, you select particular test to be a data-driven test kind of thing. That is why I showed you the collection runner where you can select and deselect some particular APIs for the data-driven test. So you write those tests as a data-driven test and then you start it. So let's start now. Let's save this file. If you need this file, you can also take it. So this is the file. I have saved the file. Let's see if we face any issue, we'll try to fix it. And let's try to run the collection runner now. So click on collection runner. Search for our particular data-driven test. Okay, so now I have to select my file. So I will select my file, make sure data is correct. Now I can see expected status code, expected response message. So data is correct. Okay, now I will run this. So before I run this, raise hand, what? Yes, Damodar. You can see my screen, right? Type one if you can see my screen. Let me see if chat is also visible. Yeah, so now it's working. So as I said, we need to see if npm, so Node.js is configured correctly. That can be seen then by running npm command. Now the first thing we need to install Newman package. So for that we would say npm install, okay, npm minus g for install it globally. npm install minus g Newman, and when you hit enter, if you don't have it, it will install it. If you have it, it will look for update and give you the message. It will take certain time, like within 30 seconds, you will get the results. No, automatically when you install Node.js as an from the installer, it will be set automatically. And if it is not set automatically, then you can set the path. Most probably it will be set automatically. So you can check it by running npm command. So in the meantime, this is being installed. I think there is a latest version. That's why it is being reinstalled. If you see the npm result, you can add the path. So path is generally when you go to the environment variables. Advanced environment variables. And I think I look for Node.js path. This would be the Node.js path. Okay. Most probably it will be installed in your program files. You can provide the path here. Automatically it will be added, like I think 90% of the time it is automatically added, but in case your system is messed up, you can add it manually. Okay. And then check by running the npm command. So when you run this, you would see all the option available for the run command. And I go one by one. I may not show the demo of everything, but the thing which we are doing using GUI, I can show you how can we do it. So this is minus E. This is where using minus E, you supply the path of the environment file, which we exported, right? Similarly, if you have a global file, then you can use minus G and provide the path of the global file. Reporters, later on we will see the reporters demo, like HTML extra reporter, command line reporter, JUnit reporter. All these reporters can be added using -add tag. Iteration count. So in the GUI mode, we were doing that in data driven testing. We were giving the iteration count on collection runner GUI, right? This is where you can use -n to run the iteration count. Minus D iteration data. This is where you provide your data file path. Okay. So to run the test using data driven test using CSV. Okay. If you are using folder, you can provide folder path. Global variable. So there are two ways to give the values. Either you can have it everything in environment files. If you don't want to have the environment file, you can say global. So in our case, we have a base URL in environment file, right? So what you can say -- environment variable and then base URL is equal to API staging dot engineer dot AI. So we are not using environment file. We are giving the file, data or dynamic data using command line. So these two options are for those. If you want to export environment, you can do it. So all the things which we were doing from GUI is actually possible using Newman also. Similarly, if you want to export collection, you can do it. If you, so Postman also has API key. If you are using API key to extract and test, let's say you are testing some, you want to get all the environment present in your workspace. So you can get that using a Postman API key and Postman API. So if you are using that kind of thing, you can use this particular thing to provide the API key and then get, let's say, environment, postman.environments in your workspace. Bail is basically to stop a collection when you encounter an error. Let's say you want to check on your first API that if the environment is up and running, only then run all other tests. Otherwise, if the first test is failing or the first API is failing, which is to check environment, then you can use this bail parameter. If there is any failure, just stop the execution. Ignore redirects, simple enough. Silent without any logging. Disable Unicode. So basically, all the characters are displayed in Unicode. You would see a table kind of results at the end of the collection run. So, but if you use same kind of command in Jenkins, you will face issues because Jenkins does not disable Unicode by default. So this is where you can use disable Unicode. Color, if you want color output. Delay request, similarly to collection runner, you can provide delay request here. Timeout, let's say I want my collection to run within maximum of say, let's say 1 minute. If it takes more than 1 minute, time it out. So here you can provide that particular value. Timeout request, if any request takes more than, let's say, 5 seconds, you want to time out, then you can use this one. Timeout script, if any script validation is taking more than, let's say, 100 milliseconds, you can time out script also. So these are all options available. So the important ones are, again, I will say these top ones. Let's do and test one by one. Okay. So the first command is Newman run command. So there are two options to run collection. One by collection file, and the second is collection URL. So let's run this. Newman run. Let's run using collection file first. So my collection file is somewhere. You can also give the path. Make sure you give the path to the collection file, which is this one. Okay. So when I run this now, it would fail because it does not know the value of base URL. If you see, base URL is not found because we did not supply the environment, right? So now I would run the same command. I hope everyone has run this. Can you type two guys if you have run this and see the same error? Because in command line, everything happens so quickly. That's why I want to confirm after every command that you are with me. Okay, let me have a chat view also in here so that I can see everything in one screen. Okay. Okay, so we were missing an environment file, right? So environment file path can be given minus E and then the file path. So if I do, so I will extract the environment file path now, which is this one. Okay. And then I run this. So now everything works like GUI mode, right? You can see the result. Let me take it here. Right? Type 3 guys, if you can see the same results like GUI. Okay, you would say why my assertion failed, right? Because so if you see, it is saying assertion failed, right? Sign in failure, sign in 2422. Why it is failing? Because we did not supply the data file, right? If we do not supply the data file, what is happening? It actually looks for one particular set, but we actually in parameters, if you remember, JSON body gave the parameter value from the data file. That's why it failed. So the next thing is to provide the data path also, data file path also. So again, you can use arrow commands. Up arrow will show you the old commands like this. Okay, down arrow will show you the new commands like this. So what I have to extract now, give the path to the data file, minus D, data file path, again I will go, or I can, let's go there. Where is my data file? This is my data file. So now you can give the data file path. Okay. So we gave the collection file path, we gave the environment file path. Now we are giving the data file path. And now when I run this, now it would match. Everything is matching with the collection runner GUI, right? Because we now gave everything which was needed for this particular collection to run successfully. Type 4 guys, if you can see the same results. Okay. This is the command. Oh, let me unzoom, guys. It is very difficult to work in a Zoom. Commands are pretty simple, actually. Newman run collection file path, then minus E, environment file path, then minus D, data file path. But you need to change your file path based on your file path, okay? My file path would be different. Once you can all see the same results which I see here, let me know. Type 6 guys, if you are ready for next step. Okay, cool. So next step is pretty easy. I will show how we can test it using collection URL. So this time we selected collection file, right? So, but I also have the collection URL. So I would see the same result if I use collection URL. Okay, but I would replace this instead of collection file, I would use here. I would replace this particular collection file to the collection URL. Okay, now I can zoom and show you. So now my command looks like this, Newman run collection URL. The other things are same, minus E path of environment file, minus D path of data file. So if I run this, again you would see the same results, right? So that is how you can run using collection URL. Let me give you the command. My niece is crying in background, so sorry for that. It has to be local system, or if you're working on server, then server. There is a way to get it as a URL using Postman API. So if you see your Postman collection, okay, on web. So if I log in Postman web, No. Actually, running through URL will take time. But the first time when you run, whether URL or Postman, it takes time. The going forward, it would be faster. Local system is faster compared to URL. URL actually depends upon network speed, right? And collection URL is your local system, so that would be faster. So now, using Postman API, again, you have to create your API, and once you have that, you can see your all the, so here you can create an API and then you can use your API. Here you can see your environment. So now using this environment, you can actually provide the path of environment also, okay? But I'll say that companies does not allow external URLs to use. That's why always maintain your repository internally or in Git, and then fetch the values, fetch these all these files locally. Okay, but if you want to, you can actually do it using API. Okay, create your API, then fetch the API environment using get API, get environments command, and then you will get a URL, then provide that URL. It's a long process, but if you really want to do it, you can do it. Okay, so if you are ready for the next command, which is, so right now we can see the result, but we don't have any reports, right? So there are number of reports available in Newman. Again, Newman provides that in terms of packages. One of them is CLI, which you see here. The second one is JUnit, which we'll be covering in Jenkins, because in Jenkins you create a JUnit report. And then you view it as a trend or history kind of thing, so that you can see later on what were my results in the previous builds. And the third one is HTML reporter, which is a basic reporter, does not have a good UI. But the final one is HTML extra, which is used in every company. That gives you everything, like it gives you iteration kind to account wise. Distribution, it gives you response request information, it gives you information about failures, script test cases, and so on. So we'll see the demo of reporter now. Type 8 guys, if you're ready for the Newman demo, sorry, Newman HTML extra demo. Okay, break, let's take it break after this final HTML demo. We'll cover Jenkins and other things later on. Okay, this is the final thing in Newman, getting the reports. Okay guys. So we need to install the HTML extra package to run our reporter, right? So HTML extra reporter, you can install npm, again npm install minus g, and then the command newman reporter HTML extra. Okay, once you do that, it would be installed. Who said about break? Saurabh. I actually uninstalled everything so that you guys see the real time thing. Quickly. Everyone, is this completed for anyone? Type 9 if you have it is completed for anyone. No? That's why I like self-hosted demo. I could just skip out all this part. Okay. So it is added. Okay. I hope it is added for everyone. Anyone? It's added now? No? Taking too much time. Okay. In the meantime, it is added. Just open the previous command. Cool. Open the previous command, which was this, like previous run command. Now we need to add one more tag here, minus R for reporter, right? So minus R for the reporter. What reporter we want to add? We want to add HTML extra. Okay, HTML extra. Now we want to also export this particular result in somewhere so that we can view it easily. So for that, we would say minus minus reporter HTML extra. HTML extra. Export, you want to export this, okay? And I would use the same file path. It's just that now I will create a new file. I'll show in the maximize view also. And I would give the file path of reporter. Let's say I would say report.html. Okay, so this would be my final command. Okay, so what I have done basically, human run collection minus e environment minus d data minus r HTML extra reporter minus reporter HTML extra export to this folder. Okay. Type 9 guys, if you are ready for seeing the report. Anyone for whom it is not completed? Only 5 people saying 9. Not find HTML extra. Did you use the correct command? Run this command. You are using dash between HTML and extra, that's why. Anyone, any other issue? Okay, so let's see when I run this. When I run this command now, you would not see the console output. Yeah. What is this? Okay guys, I think I used, let me verify whether HTML extra is correctly installed. Yeah, I think the command is correct. Newman reporter HTML extra. Newman reporter HTML extra. Yes, I think command is correct. Let me run this command as an admin, okay? Is it the same error for everyone or for somebody it worked also? Okay, so if I do the save test, if I run NN admin, let's see if I get the same result. Not this, I think HTML extra is fine. Where is my command? This is my command. What is happening, guys? This is why it is saying could not find. Oh. Yeah. I think I So HTML extra. Oh, I gave the wrong reporter here. I think that is why Nilana was also facing the issue. Slight change in the command, guys. Yeah, I think Vinay gave the correct command. So if I see the report now, I would see this one. Okay, so that is how you can view the report. Same results, right? 5 iteration, 10 assertion. You can see request, you can see failed test. If there are any iteration wide result, you can also see, right? Request response, you can see like logging purpose, report purpose, everything is there in this file. You can see the dark mode also if you want to. So this is about reporting part. Okay. Make sure you don't make mistake of dash. Okay, any questions on this now? Newman is finished. Just in case you want, see here, it did not see the result in CLI, right? Just in case you want the CLI also. So you can mention that in minus R part. So you can say CLI comma minus HTML extra.